It's like, when you walk up in the studio, we're talking shots. Yes, we are talking about shots, 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 shots. Roll my prompter so I can keep reading and not just singing. We're talking about alcohol shots, vaccine shots. This morning I've got the high-low hostess, Amanda Orso, to talk about the return of the, return of the party, like Return of the Mac. Okay, all right, I'm above everyone's head. Good morning, Amanda.
Good morning.
I'm starting the party early for you. I see that you're very subdued this morning.
That's a great segue. Let's do shots is my theme as well.
There you go. You are the high-low hostess. That's what you're known as. Mm-hmm. What does that mean?
You know, I love making entertaining and hosting parties really accessible to everybody. And I think sometimes people shy away from hosting people in their home because they're afraid of the expense, the time, the energy. And I like to just show sort of some budget options and some sort of low-end options to still create a really high-end looking party.
Oh, that makes sense. And it's, you know, some people get anxiety. There's some people that are great at throwing parties and some that really, as you said, shy away from it. So how do you make it so accessible to them? What do you have behind you?
Well, one thing I love is I love a theme party, whatever the theme is, because I think it makes it really fun for a guest, but it also keeps the host or hostess really focused. So it's an easy way for someone who isn't used to entertaining to kind of stay on one track. So of course, here today, we're talking about vaccination parties. And I think we're all itching to sort of see our friends again and celebrate really anything. And what better thing to celebrate than really being vaccinated? You know, there's such a comfort level now of all of us getting together, seeing loved ones again. So I thought, let's run with that theme. So you said it already, let's do shots. I think a welcome drink is a great way to start a party. It really sets the tone. And in this case, it really sets the vibe, shows the theme right from the beginning. I made Jello shots. I'm old school. I made Jello shots. So easy. I found these plastic syringes from Amazon, Party City. You can get a bag of 20 or 25, something like that, for $10. They're so inexpensive. Jello shots, so easy. Put them in the refrigerator.
Oh, I love that. I love that. And then when someone walks in the door, you just shoot them right in the mouth.
Exactly. But the other thing that I really love to do is that I have a lot of friends that actually abstain from alcohol, and I thought it'd be really great to create a really superfood mocktail. I think the other thing we're all focused on is our health.
Yeah.
So I created a mocktail that has just ginger and citrus and all things that are sort of good for us. And I love to have it sort of ready to go as people walk in. I like to have a mocktail just sort of ready. But in this case, clearly there are plenty of people that are going to want to turn it into a cocktail. Me included. So I took the same syringes and put them in a nice ice bucket here and filled them with, you could fill them with whatever spirit you choose, vodka, tequila, whatever. And that way people have the ability to turn their mocktail into a cocktail.
Oh, I like that.
And the great thing about these syringes is they actually hold 2 ounces, which I believe is the appropriate measurement for alcohol.
Yeah.
So the really sort of great thing about this is your alcohol is like pre-measured. So you have a great bar ready to go. You don't have to set out your vodka, your tequila, whatever it is, it's all set, it's pre-measured, and guests know exactly what they're getting.
So I love
that's
that.
How I like to start a party with the drinks and sort of get things going.
Yeah, okay, so that seems to be your main theme. Any other little thematic things that we can do for these Vax parties?
Well, definitely. So I found on Etsy, and there's a ton of them, I found these little cookie cutters, and this is a syringe and a flexed arm. So when I started making cookies, I decided to make just sort of a really beautiful charcuterie board, just get some nice cheeses and crackers, but I decided to make my own using these cookie cutters. So I took mozzarella, cheddar, and really just used the cookie cutter to cut little syringes out. I did the same with the flexed arm, and it creates just like a really fun, easy to eat, easy to make appetizer board. And another fun thing to do is I took the same cutouts, the flexed arm, and I hope the camera can see it.
Yeah, we got it.
And I made a little sandwich out of it.
Oh, cute.
And then to keep it all together, I put little picks in it. And of course I put the pick, you know, I stabbed it right through, you know, the meat of the arm where all of your guests should have gotten their vaccination. So it's just like another sort of cute thing to do. And another thing also on Etsy, so many things on Etsy, found these really fun drink tumblers. come in every, there's Pfizer, there's Moderna, there's Johnson & Johnson. They hold, I don't know, it's like 20, 30 ounces. Sort of silly. Nobody probably needs a tumbler like this, but they're fun. They're fun for decor. They're fun to kind of leave out. And then it's kind of a fun take home. You could give each guest one to take home with them, and they can use it as their water bottle for their iced coffee, whatever it is. And everybody then has a sort sort of an eco tumbler that they can take home with them. It reminds them of the celebration.
Yeah, you have to be lighthearted in these situations. So these are such great ideas. I love that syringe so much. We have to wrap it up, but if people want more information, where can they go?
Find me on my Instagram, HighLowHostess.
And HighLowHostess.com. All right, Amanda, thank you.
Thank you.
All right, we'll be right back after this break.